Spider-Man, and gathered the sea into a goblet. So that you can understand in simple terms, although it was Urdu, but I think it was understood very, very well. Today everybody says, don't understand Urdu. But if two people take the ball and start banging something and screaming on the other side, then everybody knows. But just the Bahana. I think if you make effort, we'll understand everything. There's one language that even if you don't understand it, you will know it. It's called the language of love. It's called the language of
love.
Love, it's not to do with what you hear with the ears, it's what you hear with your heart. So, Hazrat Maulana has given you the lecture for the evening, but for Barakat, so that my name is also in the register. I'm going to just give you a brief discussion. We're going to have a brief discussion on Sayyidi Al-Hadrat of the Lord. And inshallah we end after that. Guru Shri, Allahumma sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين صدق الله العلي العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الأمين المتين الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين فوطي أعظم ومن يدي سر سما مدد قبل أيدي مدد كعب أيدي ما مدد قادري من عرائي فوطي أعظم يزنم نبض الشيخ أحمد رضا خان قدر عالم يزنم سيدي يا مرشدي شاه مصطفى خان زندباد مسلک سرکار والا اعلی حضرت زندہ باد یا الہی مسلک احمد رضا خان زندہ باد یہ جناموں سے رسالت کا جو ذمہ دار ہے سیدی یا مرشدی شاہ مصطفیٰ خان زندہ باد حامل فیض رضا مصطفیٰ مدکم صلی اللہ علیہ نبی علی و علی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم صلی اللہ علیہ علی کے سیدی یا سندی یا حبیب یا قدیم یا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم علی علی کو اصحابی کے رحمت للعالمین درود و سلام upon the most perfect, exalted and glorified of Allah's creation, Sayyidina Mawlana Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These blessings and salutations upon the Anbiya Ikram, elevated Har, Sahaba Ikram, Khulafa Rashideen, Tabi'een, Tabi'e Tabi'een, Aimai Mustahideen, Awliya Kamilin, and all those who follow the path until the last day. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His infinite mercy and for the Wakil of Rasul Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for affording us the opportunity to gather here on this eve of the 25th of Safar to pay tribute and to salute the great Mujaddid of the era.
Subhanallah.
A personality who spent his entire life for the pleasure of Allah and his beloved Rasul.
Sallallahu
ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And that is none other than Sayyidi Hasanadi Sattari Ala Hadrat Imam Ishq Muhabbat Shah Imam Ahmad Raza Khan Fazil Ibn Yubi Rabi Allah Ta'ala. Before we go any further, let us all together from the depths of our heart direct the compass of our heart towards Madinatul Munawwara, and in doing so let us collectively recite the Rushan.
اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد بعد السجود والكرم وعلي كرم ومن كريم مبارك وسلم صلى عليه الصلاه والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا حبيبي يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم
صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا رحمة للعالمين. Just now, Father Ziya Mustafa Sahib was explaining to you about the maqam of the awliya Allah, and he explained something that is very important, that, and I'm going to mention it in English so you understand it clearly and better, that people have this habit of this is bigger buduruk or that is bigger buduruk. Just I'm going to explain so that you understand it properly. The biggest indeed is Ghawsepa. Ghawsepa radiallahu anhu is Sultan al-Awliya. Haja Gharib al-Nawaz is Sultan al-Hin. Ala Hadrat is Sultan al-Ashiqin. All of them have their own excellence. But you and I don't have the right to go and start, as he said, take a scale and start measuring them. What do we have to do? Like when Ala Hazrat was asked, which is big, Makkah or Medina?
Subhanallah.
Al-Hadrat was asked, which is greater, Makkah or Medina? What did he say? He said, Taiba na sahi afzal Makkah hi bara zahir. Taiba na sahi afzal Makkah hi bara zahir. Hum ishq ke bande hai, kyun baat par? We are servants of Allah, why want to get involved in all of this discussion? Our job is to love, and the beauty of Allah, let me tell you this. The beauty of Ala Hazrat Adim al Barkat radiallahu anhu is jo waqe mein Ala Hazrat se mohabbat karta. The person who truly loves Ala Hazrat, he loves everybody. He will not leave any of the awliya of Allah. Because this is what Ala Hazrat taught us. This is what Ala Hazrat radiallahu anhu taught us. People have forgotten, and I've said this before, people have forgotten that today when you put flowers on your mother and father's grave, this is because of Allah. This is because of Allah in the zaman. Today when you take chadar and you put on the cover of the awliya Allah, the mazar of the awliya Allah, this is because of Allah. Today you are making Fatiha and Gyarvi Sharif and Barvi Sharif and Chhati Sharif. This is because of the barakat of Allah Hazrat Adi wa barakat. Because when everybody was silent, Allah Hazrat spoke.
Subhanallah.
See, you must understand one thing. To talk when everybody talks is very easy. Sab jab bol rahe, to awaz mila ke bolna bahut aasan. Aur jab koi nahi bolta hai, us waqt bolna bahut mushkil. When nobody talks, to talk at that time is very difficult. And when everybody was quiet at that time, Allah Hazrat stood up, kill ke raza hai, kam jale 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 hai, Allah Hazrat stood up. What did he stand up for? He stood up because somebody took his property?
No.
He took up, stood up because somebody took his wealth? He stood up because somebody took some materialistic belonging of him? No. He stood up because the station and the excellence of the beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam was being attacked. He stood up in defense of the love of the beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. That is why we say, and the poet has explained very beautifully, he says, apne khaja se muh na morenge, damane haus hum na chhodenge. Apne khaja se muh na morenge, damane haus hum na chhodenge, aur jalne wale jale magar hum to rishta Ahmad Raza se
jodh.
No matter whatever happens, we will keep our connection to Ala Hazrat Adhimul Barkat radiallahu ta'ala. And today we talk about Ala Hazrat, and it's a long Ala Hazrat. Let me tell you, Ala Hazrat radiallahu, just now Maulana said that if you look at the work of Allah, now again I'm not saying this with pride, I'm saying this as tahdees and ni'mah. Last year I completed a book, 200 pages on the life of Ala Hazrat. It's just the start. Last night I completed the second 200 pages, second volume. Inshallah, it will be launched online tomorrow. And we'll be publishing. And as the more you write on Ala Hazrat, the more you realize that Ala Hazrat is no more about one person. Ala Hazrat is a subject.
Ala
Hazrat has become a science.
Subhanallah.
Allah Hadrat has become a science. Subject. Razviyat has become a subject.
Subhanallah.
Allah Hadrat Adimul Bargat. Now, as Marana Ziyam Samasat explained to you, can you imagine one man, this was one man, who wrote more than 1,200 books and treaties on more than 54 and some say 65 sciences of knowledge. If you talked about trigonometry, then he wrote on trigonometry. If you talk about algebra, then he wrote about algebra. If you talked about geomorphology, he wrote about geomorphology. If you talked about astronomy, he wrote about astronomy. The vice chancellor of the Aligarh University, Dr. Sir Ziauddin, who was a master mathematician, he came and he humbled himself at the feet of Allah. And he said, that question, which or that mathematical problem that I needed to travel to Germany to resolve, the Imam of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'at resolved it in seconds in front of
him.
In moments he resolved it. And what did he say? He said, aaj mujhe pata chala ki ilm ladunni waqi mein. He said, today I realized there's something called inspired knowledge. Allah Hazrat radiallahu anhu didn't go and study this from anything or from anyone. Allah Hazrat himself says, this is the blessing of Muhammadur Rasulullah. So a personality
who wrote on 54, almost 54 and more sciences, who in 65 years of his life has written more than 1,200 books and treatises. And I said this before, one book after being categorized, only one book, I'm leaving the other books, one book after being categorized, Fatawa Razviya Sharif, is approximately 30,000 pages.
Subhanallah.
One book.
Allah.
One book. When the Wahhabis went to Haram in front of the Sharif of Makkah, and they lied about the ilm al-ghayb, and they rejected the ilm al-ghayb of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they gave false evidence and false proof, and they gave information to take a fatwa. They took istifta to take a fatwa from the ulama of Makkatul Mukarrama, including great personalities like Hazrat Sayyidina Allama Sheikh Saleh Qamal radiallahu ta'ala an. When Ala Hazrat went to his Hajj, and when Ala Hazrat met them, and those ulama, when they saw Ala Hazrat and listened to his words, I'm being brief, they listened to his words, what did they say? They looked at Ala Hazrat and they said, "You are Ziauddin.
Subhanallah.
You are the light of religion. The nur of Islam is glowing in your forehead."
Subhanallah.
They sat with Ala Hazrat radiallahu anh, and after sitting with Ala Hazrat radiallahu anh, the questions that came to Sheikh Saleh Kamal, he took it and squashed it and put it one side. And he gave Ala Hazrat the pen and paper. And he said, "You write the answer to these people.
Subhanallah.
You write the answer to these people. This is what you call the ata of Rasul-e-Pak. This is what is al-ataya al-nabawiyya. It is the blessing of the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Wahhabis had a battle with Ala Hazrat in India because he fought against them for haq. They went to Makkah and Medina to try and get fatwa against the Akabirin and go against what he and the other great scholars like Allama Salamatullah, etc. We say, Ali Marhamah Ridwan. But when they got there, and just then Ala Hazrat gets there for Hajj, Sheikh Saleh Kamal takes their question and he gives it to Ala Hazrat. This is the den of Rasul-e-Pak. That unke jawab, unke hasan.
The
answer in the hand of Ala Hazrat. Ala Hazrat wrote that answer. He wrote that answer on Ilm al-Ghayb in 8 hours.
Subhanallah.
He wrote that answer in 8 hours to form a Dawlatul Makkiyah bil Ma'datil
Ghaybiyya.
And now it's gone 101 years since his wisal. We're not counting before that.
Yeah.
More than 101 years since the wisal of Ala Hazrat radiallahu anhu, up to today, not one of them have been able to give the jawab of one line in the
Tawbah.
The ulama of Haramain Tayyibain got together, and then came the beautiful Hussamul Haramain, in which they said clearly about the Wahhabis, about these Deobandis. What did they say? Man shakka fi kufrihi wa adabihi faqad kafar. Whomsoever doubts such people's kufr or their adab, he becomes kafir just like them. Why? Because of what they wrote about Rasul-e-Pak sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What they said in their books. Ala Hadrat protected the iman. What Maulana Sahib was telling you, protection of the iman. In reality, see that you have to understand. Sultanul Hind Khaja Ghandinawaz is Sultanul Hind. Ala Hadrat himself said he's Sultanul Hind. People say Sultanul Hind today. This is the barakat of Ala Hadrat. People say that Ala Hadrat then he was Muslim. Allahu Akbar. In 1323, when Ala Hazrat made Hajj, and when he came back from Hajj, and when Hazrat Burhan Millat radiallahu's father said to him, "Okay, I want you to come to Jabalpur," he said, "This time I can't come. After Hajj, I made niyat, I'm going straight to Ajmer Sharif. I'm going straight to the Bar of Sultanuddin, Khaja Gharibun Nawaz radiallahu ta'ala. Ala Hazrat Adimul Barakat, Khaja Gharibun Nawaz radiallahu's khidmat was that he brought the people to Islam. And to keep the people on the Islam of Khaja was the job of Ala Hazrat.
Subhanallah.
Keep them on the Islam which Khaja gave them.
Subhanallah.
Khaja gave that Islam to that community. But to keep them on that footing was the work of Ala Hazrat. So in reality, Ala Hazrat is the blessing of Sarkari Khaja.
Subhanallah.
We have to understand this. Ala Hazrat Adimul Barkat's life, we can talk for hours about Imam Ahmad Azhar and about his services for the deen. Enough we have to understand is this. If you just, you know, let me tell you something. People ask about Ala Hazrat Adimul Barakat radiallahu anhu, that why every second word you people talk Ala Hazrat? Ala Hazrat. Ala Hazrat. Why shouldn't I want to ask the same question which Malana just asked, was talking about. You people didn't learn Ala Hazrat, we didn't learn from today. The roving ambassador of Islam, Hazrat Maulana Abdul Aleem Siddiqui Mirdi radiallahu anhu. Do you know what people talk about? Probably talk about Maulana Aleem Siddiqui. Maulana Abdul Aleem Siddiqui Mirdi radiallahu anhu was the murid, the khalifa, and the student of Allah radiallahu anhu. He was the roving ambassador, but he was the product of Allah. He was the product of the spiritual factory of Allah. Maulana Abdul Aleem Siddiqui radiallahu anhu. That is why when Allah Hazrat, when he came back from Hajj, when Maulana Abdul Aleem Siddiqui came back from Hajj, he wrote an entire kalam praising Allah. He wrote an entire kalam praising Allah Hazrat, and he read it with such love that Allah Hazrat stood up and said, "What do I give you for what you have said? Yet I am not worthy of it." He took his jubbah and he gave it to him. And what did Maulana Abdul Aleem Siddiqui do? He kissed it and he kept it on top of his head. He didn't wear it. Kissed it and put it on his head. So these great personalities, Hazrat Sadr Sharia radiallahu anhu, Tariqa, Bahari Sharia, we hear about.
Subhanallah.
The fiqh, encyclopedia of Hanafi fiqh today. Who was he? He was the murid and the khalifa of Allah. You hear names like Mufti Mahmud Jan Peshawari radiallahu anhu, the person who designed the gumbad of Allah. Who was he? He was the murid and the khalifa of Allah radiallahu anhu. He was so much older than Allah Hazrat radiallahu anhu, but he came from Afghanistan looking for a peer. He went from Afghanistan looking for a murshid. He was over 20 years more, or 25 years older, more than that, older than Allah Hazrat radiallahu anhu. But he went all over looking for a murshid. He said, "I found the murshid in Bareilly."
Subhanallah.
Who Allah Hazrat radiallahu anhu.
Subhanallah.
These are the great personalities that could be Medina. Hadrat Shaykh Ziauddin Madani radiallahu anhu, who was he? He was the murid of Allah Hazrat
radiallahu anhu. Subhanallah.
Shaykh Sunnat Hazrat Hashmat Ali Khan radiallahu anhu, who was he? He was the Khalifa and the murid of Allah Hazrat Adim al Barakat. He became murid through the waqalat of Hadrat Sadr Sharia.
Subhanallah.
But they were all the murids of Allah Hazrat Adim al Barakat radiallahu ta'ala. So today, that this faizan around the world of Ahl Sunnah that you see, this is the blessing of Allah Hazrat Adim al Barakat radiallahu anhu. People ask today, you know, Allah Hazrat Imam Ahl Sunnat radiallahu ta'ala, tell me some of his karamats. Today the first thing when you hear about any budrug, you want to hear karamat. Today if you want to see the person flies, then you say he's somebody. That's what, that's how become our mentality. Pehle dekho ki dikhao ki ur sakte ki. See if you can fly first. See if you can do this, and you must be able to see this. Then you know, oh, this is a big poncha. What is a poncha? Poncha. Hazrat Junaid Baghdadi said about those giants like this. He said, "Ponch chuke." He said, "Magar kahan tak jahannam ke darwaze?" He said, "They've reached until where? They've reached the door of hell." By trying to corrupt the people. The biggest karamat, the biggest karamat according to Surendra Sayyidina Junaid Baghdadi is istiqamat. Firmness on the Shariat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. People ask, first thing, you want to ask, people said, I said, Allah, tell me some karamats of Allah. I said, leave me telling you the karamats of Allah. Allah Hadrat was a mu'ajaza of Rasulullah
sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. He was a miracle from the miracle. He is a miracle from the miracles of Rasulullah
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
And if you want to talk about Allah's karamats, then Fatawa Razviya is a karamat.
Subhanallah.
Fatawa Razviya is a karamat. الدوله المكيه بالماده الغيبيه is a karama. وسام الحرمين is a karama. هدايه بخشيش is a karama. العون علا is a karama. If you want to know about karamas, every letter, every word that Allah Hazrat wrote was a karama. Allah Hazrat standing, you want to know about Allah Hazrat's biggest karama? His biggest karama is to stand in the defense of the beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he stood up by himself and did not care about his health, he did not care about his life, he did not care about anything. What did he say? He said that I don't care if people swear me. You know when letters used to come to Allah Hazrat? And people would write vulgar words against Allah Hazrat. People read the letters to Allah Hazrat, would read the letters and they would hide sometimes. Sometimes they would read it. Once they saw, very briefly, one of the beloved murids of Allah Hazrat, what did he say? He said, Huzur, that these people write so many bad things against you. He says, let's do this against them and let's do that against them. He said, let them be. In the time that they are writing against me, at least in that time they are not writing against Rasulullah.
Subhanallah.
What was this? What was this? This was love. People go on talking about love. You want to know about love? Go and look at the Imam of love.
Subhanallah.
Look at Allah Hazrat Adim al-Barakat. I know when we were still children. Today, آج لوگ اعلی حضرت کے خلاف بولتے ہیں, ایسے لوگوں کے لیے تباہی اور بربادی. They will be destroyed. They will be destroyed if you talk against anybody. Anybody. And especially Sarkare Ala Hazrat. Because Sarkare Ala Hazrat radiallahu anhu is the representative of the Awliya. They have made him their representative. That is why his murshid, their khandan of Mahrara Muqaddasa, what did they say? They said Ala Hazrat is the chashma chiragh.
Subhanallah.
He is the eyes of the khandan-e barkat and he is the lamp of the barkati khandan. If you want to see something, you have eyes and you don't have a lamp in the dark, you can't see. You have eyes and you don't have a lamp, you can't see. So that is why he's the chiragh. And you have the lamp and you don't have eyes, you still can't see. So they didn't say he's the chasham or the chiragh. They said he's the chasham and the
chiragh
of khandan-e barkat. He's the vision of khandan-e barkat. He's the lamp of khandan-e barkat. That is why you just heard, what did Hafiz Sahib, what did his murshid say? Sayyidina Ali Rasool, Mahrari radiyallahu, Roz Mahshar agar mujhse poochhe Allah, bol Ali Rasool, تو لایا ہے کیا؟ عرض کر دوں گا لایا احمد رضا. یا خدا یہ امانت اعلی حضرت قدیم البرکت رضی اللہ عنہ. اعلی حضرت لائف واز سو ایوری تھنگ واز اباؤٹ دی کمانڈ آف اللہ رسول صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. اینڈ آئی ایم گونا گیو یو ون ایگزامپل. اینڈ اف یو وانٹ ٹو لرن, لک, وی آر وی اسپینڈ اینڈ حضرت ول ٹیل یو, دی علماء ول ٹیل یو آلسو, اذرز ہیئر, یو آل نو. لیٹس آسک ون کوسچن. آئی ڈونٹ وانٹ یو ٹو آنسر می الون بیکاز آئی نو واٹ آنسر اٹس گوئنگ ٹو بی. آئی نو دی آنسر. Right? How many hours do you spend on WhatsApp in a day? Don't answer. Don't tell me about it. How many hours do you spend on Facebook? How many hours do you spend on Twitter? How many hours do you spend on the rest of social media? Keep that question in your mind. How many hours do you spend learning about the deen of Allah? How many hours do you spend reciting the Holy Quran? How many hours do you spend reciting Durood Sharif? How many hours do you spend learning about the life of your master and my master Muhammad Rasulullah? I know the answer, you know the answer. But why is it that after knowing the answer, we're still not rectifying the situation? Have we forgotten something that is very important? Have we forgotten something that is very, very, very important? Let me remind myself, and I'm reminding you. Every time that you decide to sit on Facebook or Twitter and do something that is haram, yes, it can be used for, your WhatsApp can be used for a beneficial reason, but most people use this for khurafa. Alhamdulillah, I'm not on Facebook. I'm not on Twitter. The only thing I use is my phone to send some broadcast messages or dini messages that people need. I know they ask some questions. Otherwise, I'm not on social media, okay? I'm not saying you shouldn't, if you're there for the right reasons, it's a different story. But I've noticed and I've heard from people and I've seen people send me sometimes screenshots of this and that. If there's some controversial issue, somebody swearing somebody or something, you will get 500,000, 2,000 people giving likes and getting involved in that. But you send something about deen zarurat, not one or two people, three people, 10 people. What is the reason for that? What is the reason for that? Because you attract it to nonsense. We become attracted to fitna and fasad, rather than being attracted towards ruhaniyat and goodness.
Allah, Allah.
One answer to all of these things. One answer to all of these things. One thing that will wake us up. If it don't wake us up, nothing will wake us up. More. Death. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the greatest nasiha is death. If we don't learn, those before us are gone. Those before us are gone, and don't think you and I are going to stay here forever. We are going to go. What are you going to take and go from this dunya? Your factory? Your properties? Your bank balance? You leave everything behind for your children. And that too, nowadays, they don't remember. Children forget after 40 days who their father was. Illa mashallah. They forget who their mother was. They forget that the father worked blood and sweat. The mother would sit with them day and night and care for them. But when they become parents, then they start thinking by then it's too late. They don't have no value for their parents. Ala Hazrat Adimul Barkat explains clearly, same imam, that a person goes for his farz, hajj, it's farz. But after his Farad Hajj, if he wants to go for Nafil Hajj or any other important zarurat and his mother is alive, without the ijazat of his mother, he can't go. Can't go. But today we don't care. So the point is that death should wake us all up and make us realize Ala Hadrat radiallahu's life was about this. Once he was asked, I'm being brief, that Hudur, every question we ask you, on your zuban the answer is there. On your zuban the answer is there. You don't have to go and look at the book. Tears came into his eyes. He said, you're asking me about books, that I should go and look into the books. He said, when I go into my cupboard and with the Nakirain are going to question me, where am I going to bring books from at that time? Where am I going to go and bring books from at that time? What is going to be my hal at that time? Allah Hazrat taught us what is caution. He taught us piety, and I'm ending with this today. Understand, otherwise there's a lot to say. Understand, I'm going to give you one waqi, ek waqi. Usse agar, ispe agar aap thoda ghaur kare, if you think about this one waqi, it will change your life. It will change your life. It's a simple one. Ala Hadrat Adhimul Barakat radiallahu anhu, most close and most beloved murid or khadim, one of his closest khuddam, was Haji Kifayatullah rahmatullahi ta'ala, who was buried in the same building as the mazar of Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu, towards the left, as you enter the mazar, on the left hand side is his qabr shed. Haji Kifayatullah rahmatullahi ta'ala. He was drowned in the love of his worship. Okay? He used to be with him day and night. He saw that Ala Hadrat radiallahu anhu, when we came to the masjid, in those days they didn't have electricity in the building. They had used the lanterns and they used lamps. But Ala Hadrat gave a fatwa, I'm giving you in brief, I gave a ruling, that you should not burn the lamp or the lantern in the masjid. Not in the masjid. Why? Because two reasons. In those days, the matches, because they burnt with matches, the matches came from Norway. And it had a very bad smell because of the sulfur. So when you lit it in the masjid, it gave a bad smell for a long time in the masjid. And he said to burn anything that gives badabu in the masjid is not chance. Look at the caution. To burn anything that gives a bad smell in the masjid is not chance. And secondly, in those days, they used to put paraffin into the lantern. And paraffin has a bad smell. The other thing that they burnt was mustard oil, mustard seed oil. Had a very bad smell. So Allah radiallahu anhu said that this should not be burnt in the masjid. In other words, it's burnt on the outside, on the side. And they should leave the lamps on the side for the sills. And the light used to come inside, but not inside the masjid. This was his caution. Look at his caution. One day, Haji Kifayatullah rahmatullahi ta'ala, he noticed that it was windy season. And the wind was blowing. The lamp would go off every time they have to light it. Because they were lighting it outside. Right? He wouldn't allow them to light it inside. So what he did, he took a blank lantern, an empty lantern, and he put four glass on it. On the four sides he put glass. So he made a proper lantern. And in where the oil burns into the little container, he didn't put any bad smelling oil. He put an oil, arandika there. In other words, it's a castor oil. He put that oil inside. So it doesn't give a bad smell when you burn it. And then when Allah Hadrat left his house that day, he walked with Allah Hadrat with the lantern. When they got to the masjid, he took the lantern and he kept it inside the masjid because now it didn't have a bad smell. Now it didn't have a bad smell. He kept it inside the masjid. Allah Hadrat Adimul Barakat also in the masjid. As after a few moments, Allah Hadrat's nazar fell upon the lantern in the masjid. Allah Hadrat looked at it and got upset and he said, Haji Sahab, how many times have you seen my fatwa? That you should not burn a lamp and lantern in the mosque because of the smell. How many times have you seen it? Haji Sahib said, Huzur, this is not the bad smelling oil. This is not that bad smelling oil. This oil does not have a bad smell. Look at Allah's answer. I want you to listen to Allah's answer. Allah has said that I know that, you know that, the people that are walking in the street, do they know that? The people outside, the uneducated, the laymen, do they know that? They will say, Allah Hazrat gives fatwa ki isko masjid mein mat jala. Aur woh apne masjid mein jala rahe. He gives fatwa that don't burn it in the mosque. But he's burning it in the mosque. But that man does not know that it is not that oil. Haji Sahab, if you're willing to sit next to the lamp, and everybody that goes past telling that this is not the bad oil, it's the other oil. This is not the bad oil, it's the other oil. I have no objection. Yes, samajhne ki baat hai, especially for other ulama. That beware of where you go and who you stay with and who you sit with. Because what you do has a reaction on the community. What we do has a reaction on the community. Even you as Muslims, be careful what you do because it has an action on your community. That is why the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that you should stay away from places of doubt and matters of doubt. Now this was Allah's caution, Allahu Akbar. Look at his caution. Just take this one incident and understand his caution. How careful he was. That you and I may know it, but the others won't know it. So do not do that which causes a doubt in the community. Do not do that which causes doubt. This was Allah's caution in deen matters. This is the same Allah. If we can go on tonight about just talking about the personality that we're celebrating tonight. But enough for us to understand that he stood his entire life for the pleasure of Allah. He fought against those who spoke against Allah and his beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and who came in the garb of Muslims. They were wolves in sheepskin. Allah Hazrat radiallahu anhu unveiled them. He made their deviance and their corruption zahir. He protected the iman of the Muslims. And people want to ask again, ara this karamat? I said, Mustafa Jaane Rahmat pe laakho
salaam.
Mustafa Jaane Rahmat pe laakho salaam. Go into any nook and corner of the world, you will find one man who's reading Mustafa Jaane Rahmat. This is the karamat. This is the blessing. Why did he get this blessing from the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Because of his loyalty. Because of his sincerity. Do you know when he went to Madina Sharif and to Makkah Sharif, and when the great ulama of Makkah and Medina gave him honor and gave him respect, some of the akadirin of Madinatul Munawwara, the big ulama of Madinatul Munawwara, the big ulama, you know what they said? They said, we desire that we should kiss your feet and your slippers.
Allahumma.
We should kiss your feet and your slippers. This is what they said to Allah. You know what Allah said? He said, I am an insignificant speck.
Allahumma.
I am an insignificant speck in front of these great personalities. The reason that they are giving me this honor is because of Muhammadur Rasulullah. Sarkari Ala Hazrat is standing in a masjid. He's delivering a lecture in Bombay. Kasai Mohalla. He's delivering a lecture in the masjid. While he's delivering a lecture, it was a Jummah. After the Jummah, they have the lectures in those days, they have afterwards. So he was delivering the lecture, speaking on the Mawlud of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People were, they said there was no place to put one tinka in the masjid. No place to put one little, like a matchstick anywhere in the mosque. That's how full it was. People were listening to the lecture of Allah Hazrat radiallahu anhu. And you can imagine, today we speak, Allah Hazrat said that he was insignificant. I regard myself as the most insignificant. And yet when we speak to you, we talk to you, look at your attention. Can you imagine how it was when Allah had this? Can you imagine how it was when Allah had this? Can you imagine the sea of knowledge that used to flow from his best lips? So Allah is delivering the lecture, and the crowd is full in the masjid, and Allah radiallahu anhu is talking about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And there is a young man, a young boy, a youngster, who is sitting beside the wall. And while he is listening to the lecture, Allah is speaking for over an hour. Yeah. And while he's listening to Allah's lecture, he says that I could feel the place and the atmosphere was different. Something ajab ho raha tha. And in that condition, suddenly my eyes closed. Suddenly my eyes closed. I could not keep my eyes open. It's not because I was tired. It was not because I was bored, ma'adullahi rabbil. But I could not keep for that moment my eyes open. And my eyes closed, and the moment my eyes closed, he said, I could see that there was noor everywhere. I was in a different place, there was noor. And I could see light, and I could feel light, and I could not understand this condition that I was in. He said, then I heard there was a loud recitation. And what was the recitation? Of Salatu Salamu Alaika Ya Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So I got up, when I opened my eyes, I see Allah Hazrat has left the minbar. He's standing on the masjid ground and his hands are tied and he's reading salam on the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the entire crowd is standing up and they also reading. I quickly got up and I started to read also, the young boy says. I'm also reading salam, but I'm trying to figure out that the program is not finished as yet. Why did Ala Hazrat start reading salam? Program is not finished yet. Ala Hazrat started to read salam. He says, I'm listening. I'm also reading. I'm also thinking what just happened to me just now. He says, in this condition, Ala Hazrat is tearing. Tears are flowing from his eyes. He completes the Salatu Salam in great emotion. Thereafter gets back on the minbar, again gives some lecture and finishes the program after some time. He says, I could not understand. I came out of the mahfil. I said to my father and my chacha, I said, I don't know what happened. Can you explain to me? This is what happened to me in the masjid. My eyes closed. I saw light and nur everywhere. But I was awoken by the sound of durood. And when I saw it was Allah standing and giving salam. What is happening? His father said to him when they got home, repeat what you saw. Repeat what you saw. Again he repeated. His father kissed him on his eyes and he said to the young boy, he said to the young man, he said, one day you will be somebody. You are very fortunate. You are very fortunate of what you have seen. They say the next day in the morning, they all went to meet Ala Hazrat. When they went, Ala Hazrat Alimul Barkat radiallahu anhu, respected his father, was a great Alim Adir. I'm being brief. Ala Hazrat got up and they greeted Ala Hazrat. Ala Hazrat made my father sit next to him. He says, and then we saw an old man with a white beard, so the topi, white kurta. He was sitting next to Ala Hazrat. Tears were in his eyes. And then he says that I heard what the old man was saying to Ala Hazrat. He was saying something. What did he say? The old man was saying that yesterday, Ala Hazrat, I was sitting in the middle of the masjid while you were lecturing. My eyes closed for a moment. I saw nur all over the place. I was in the middle of the masjid. I saw nur all over the place. And suddenly I was awakened by your recitation of Salatu Salam. I stood up and I recited Salatu Salam. Oh, Ala Hazrat Radhiyallahu Anhu, what is this? At that time, the young man says, my father said to Ala Hazrat Azimul Barkat, Huzoor, my son also had the same experience in your mahfil yesterday. Who was that young man? Burhan-e-Millat. Hazrat Burhan-e-Millat, who grew up to be the Khatimul Khulafa. One of the great Khulafa of Ala Hazrat Radhiyallahu Anhu. And he says at that time, what did Ala Hazrat say? Ala Hazrat Radhiyallahu Anhu said, indeed the beloved Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was present. Indeed the beloved Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was present. Hence he stood up. Rasul-e-Pak dressed us in the mahfil on that day. It makes me think that Subhanallah, Subhanallah. Ala Hazrat is in the mahfil. Rasul-e-Pak Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam jalwa afroz hote. Ala Hazrat is able to see. Others are seeing just nur. Their eyes closed in a spiritual sleep and they are seeing nur. And Ala Hazrat with his eyes is seeing Rasul-e-Pak Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I understand from this he is live there also. Rasul-e-Pak is lecturing and Ali bin Hajar, he is sitting in the front and he is seeing in his dream Rasul-e-Pak. And Ali Sadiq Rasul-e-Pak come down from the minbar, ties with his hand tied, stands with his hand tied. Everybody after the man is saying, oh Sheikh Abdul Qadir, why did you come down from the minbar and stand in front of the sleeping man? He said in his dream he was seeing the Nabi. Abdul Qadir was seeing the eyes of his head. So this is that Ala Hazrat is now here also. How fortunate we are. How khushnaseeb we are to have nisbat to Ala Hazrat. That is why hold firm to maslaki Ala Hazrat. Hold firm to the way of Huzur Sayyidi Taj Sharia. Radiallahu anhu. Huzur Taj Sharia, radiallahu anhu, is the Qutbul Aqtab. He's the Qutbul Aqtab. Huzur Taj Sharia, radiallahu anhu, is that personality who gave us the drink of the love of Ala Hazrat Adim Abdul Qadir, radiallahu anhu. Huzur Taj Sharia ka naam hum log lete hai. We take Ala Hazrat's name, but very sad. Today you'll see people, Ala Hazrat, Ala Hazrat, Urse Ala Hazrat, Urse Ala Hazrat, mein khub video ho raha hai. Urse Ala. Ala Hazrat, Ala Hazrat. Posters with photographs of on top of it. Is this what Ala Hazrat wanted?
No.
Is this what Ala Hazrat taught us? No. Was this the life of Ala Hazrat? This is not praising Ala Hazrat. This is hurting Ala Hazrat. This is hurting Ala Hazrat. There are two ways of doing something. The right way and the wrong way. Why do you want to do it the wrong way? Why do you want to do it the wrong way? Do it the right way. And you must remember, we must learn one thing in life. Jo baat bolne ka hai, wo bol dena chahiye. What needs to be said must be said, whether anybody likes it or not. We must be straight and frank about these things. Why? Because neither will you answer for me, nor will I answer for you. When we go in the grave, we're going to be answering for ourselves. Ala Hazrat Radhiyallahu Anhu, follow his way. Follow the way of Ala Hazrat, the maslak of Ala Hazrat. Huzur Sayyidi Muhaddis Kabir is the greatest representative of the court of Ala Hazrat, Adim al-Barkat radiallahu anhu. And learn from the mashayikh, learn from the great scholars, how to love the beloveds of Allah. Learn how to love the awliya of Allah. And in the words of Ala Hazrat, the end today, Suna Jangal, Raat Andheri, Nari Badrin Sadi, Sone Bale,
جاگتے رہیو چوروں کی رکھوالی ہے. اما دن نظرہ للہ سکانہ فسلہ فسلہ میں نمائے.